So I eaten in the book, me. So bananas were eaten by me. Okay. Next, they called me. I was called by them. So in future tense. Okay. He, she, it, they. In future tense. Future tense. Okay. He, she, it, they. Banana. Subject plus verb plus object. Helping verb. Will. Helping verb. So modal auxiliaries, that means helping verbs. Auxiliaries, that means none other than helping verbs. When it comes to the helping verbs, the bananas will be eaten by him. Okay. So these are the, so these are active and passive voice. In present tense, come to know that how to use, and in past tense and in future tense. Okay, I hope you understand this concept. Next class, so I will tell you the past, present continuous tense, in the past continuous and future continuous tense. How it is changes. So nothing will change. A bit of the sentence will be changed. Understand? I will tell you in the next class. So hope you understand. So I will tell you the first, that is present tense, that means simple present tense. We use is for the singular, are for the plural. Okay, that means helping verbs. That means that indicates the tenses. Okay, that one. And most importantly, subject plus verb plus object. So in active voice and passive voice, when it comes active voice and passive voice, you should remember that the what? Subject plus verb plus object. It is the biggest formula and it is an important formula you can remember, and it helps in every time. And one more thing is, you can, in active and passive voice, you can change the subject in the place of subject. So you can write the object. And so verb as it is same, the place of object you can write the subject. So it is one thing. And another one important thing is, you can just observe the sentence is in which tense. So these are the main rules, and by preposition is must in passive voice. Okay, hope you understand. Thank you, dear students.